This is the Darrell Walker Coaches Show, presented by Stevens. And now, head coach of your Trojans, Darrell Walker. College basketball season winding down. Postseason tournaments upon us. And Darrell Walker, your ball club, final week of the season, hit the road for a couple of road games.
Yeah, we had SIU Edwardsville. We had Lindenwood. All of them were game sevens. And, you know, unfortunately, we couldn't pull it out.
Both of them very exciting games. You had to have a win to try to continue your season. 1-1 and lost one.
Yeah, 1-1 and lost one. SIU Edwardsville game I thought was a heck of a game. We had our chances at Lindenwood up 13, 14, 15 points with 5-6 minutes left in the game. And basically, that's just the way our year has been the whole year.
I do want to explain our backdrop back here. Our floor is missing. We played on a temporary floor this year because of some water issues. And so we're getting a new floor. So this is not what the Stevens Center looks like. Speaking of those two games, we'll break them down. We'll come back with more of the Darrell Walker Coaches Show.
It's time to expect more from yourself, from us, from the typical college experience. UA Little Rock offers world-class programs, including business, computer science, criminal justice, cybersecurity, engineering, and nursing. But there's so much more. Expect to be amazed by state-of-the-art facilities. Expect to be challenged by motivated faculty. And expect a welcome place in the heart of Arkansas. University of Arkansas at Little Rock.
Sport builds us up. It strengthens our bodies. It strengthens our resolve. Sport teaches us lessons of grace or humility or humanity, and that we're far more powerful together, winning the hour or winning the year. We're winning our lives. We're winning our way. Because while a season is short, fierce is forever.
Game one was SIU Edwardsville, and a game that it was a must win for us, coach.
Yes.
And your team played really well.
I thought we played well from the beginning to the end. A lot of guys played well. I think Myron had a double-double. We moved the ball, we passed the ball around, and we got up and down the court and do what we do.
All right, let's take a peek.
Had a good crowd there. That's a nice facility there. Throwing the ball into Nigel John right there, trying to establish him right away in the post. It's a nice move by him right there on the big fella. Really nice move with the left hand. And both teams played pretty good basketball, and both teams wanted to win. But I thought we had a game seven mentality, man. We really did. And dish off there to Pruitt for an easy dunk right there. That's Myron driving the basket right there. Nice offensive rebound there by Ethan Speaker. You know, this team was ready to play. We were ready to play.
He didn't leave the floor when he shot
that. He never leaves the floor. C.J. White pushed the ball up the court. Man, we really get the ball up the court right there. A good pass to Myron, back to C.J. for a shot. You know, we did some pressure, and you know we press and trap a lot. Try to speed the game up. I think we're at our best when we speed the game up. So that's what we do a lot. But overall, it was a good basketball game. That's D.J. coming off a little pick and roll action. Wide open shot there for Myron Gardner, who played well. I think thought the whole team played well. I thought our intensity was good from the beginning to the end. And when you're on the road, that's really what you have to do. And I thought we were exceptionally well offensively. Should have came down and doubled down to help on the little fella DJ down there. There's a mismatch in the post right there. You know, I thought De'Anthony Gordon played well. Jordan Jefferson making a nice move right here on the baseline for a jump shot.
You know, the last six or eight games of the season, you always have four or five guys in double figures.
Yeah, I mean, we push the ball. We play at a fast pace. We probably was 30 or 35th in the country in pace of play rate out of 363 Division I teams. So we really push the basketball. Nice move by D.J. Smith right there to count that basket before halftime. That was good for us. Tried to establish Nigel John again in the post, backing him down. And, you know, big fella, I thought he was really good for us, man. He really played well, gave us a post presence. Gave us a really nice post presence.
Just has a knack for getting into foul trouble and coming over to sit with you.
Along with Myron Gardner.
Yeah.
Those guys are always in foul trouble, unfortunately for us. bad defense right there by Myron, just one pass for a shot. He has to get better to that next year. But overall, I thought we executed. We just played basketball, man. A beautiful pass right there on the mismatch in the post to Nigel for a little hook shot in the lane. We took care of the basketball pretty much and played the way that we play. Was more consistent than this basketball game. Once again, nice move by Nigel again. Nice move, very nice move.
Myron did have another double-double in this game.
Yeah, he's played well. Bad defensive mistake by C.J. White right there. You can't leave the guy with the basketball. You can never leave the guy with the basketball. We just kept posting D.A. They doubled, and we were able to get shots out of the double team. And we shot the ball pretty well, and we moved the ball pretty well. When we move the ball and make shots, I always tell you, Ray, we're pretty dangerous. Court is spaced open right there. Nice move by C.J., who played well the last 10, 12 games of the year. Really, really came on and played well for us. Bad defensive mistake gives Mr. Taylor, first team all OVC, a wide open jump shot right there. A mishap again defensively gives him another. No, he got 19, but we gave him at least 9 on easy 3-point shots on defensive mistakes right there. But he's a good basketball player. And they're a solid basketball team. We're able to come in there and really get after these guys. Once again, it's Mr. Taylor again with another jumper. He had at least 4 threes, and they all came in the second half.
Because we had issues running guys off the
three-point line was a nightmare for us defending it. That's D.A. who you saw the improvement of him all year long, Ray. Really played well. Played well in this game for us. Pretty good rotation right there, but they were able to keep coming and get an easy basket right there. Now, this game went back and forth. They made a run and got back in the game because of this guy, Rayshon Taylor, right there. Just really a good basketball player, really good guard. This is a guard league. You know, once again, here we go down the stretch, doing stuff that we shouldn't do. A CJ fouling right there. He shouldn't have fouled, should have made the basket. You know, another shot by Taylor right there, but luckily we had enough lead to overcome this and try to get the ball in bounds, and we did. And was able to win the game, I do believe, 79-74.
That was a final in that one.
Yeah.
That was our first trip to Evansville.
Nice facility, nice town. It was fun. We had a chance to stay in St. Louis.
And from there, we went to Lindenwood.
Yeah.
And beautiful campus. Looked like Ivy League school.
It is there. Ivy League school.
Nice facilities.
Nice private school. Great facilities.
And a big crowd.
And a really nice, boisterous crowd. It was a good college atmosphere.
We put ourselves in a position. We won that one, so now we're playing for the 8th slot in the conference tournament with these guys. The winner of this one goes.
The winner of all. Once again, it's another game 7, so it went. We had control of the basketball game, and then the last 6 minutes of the game, Ray, just to be honest about it, I thought we just folded. I thought we folded offensively and defensively.
Yes, we did. Let's take a look at the highlights. This was a heck of a college basketball game.
Great atmosphere.
Yeah, if you're a fan,
it's a great atmosphere, man.
There's Nigel
atmosphere.
On the block to start off.
Start off, got an easy shot. Couldn't make it. Got it tipped in by D'Anthony Gordon. I thought we had control of this game. I thought our defense was pretty solid. You know, we just couldn't close it out. Got to get your hand up. Got to get your hand up. Got to get your hand up. I knew they didn't have anybody to guard D'Anthony Gordon. I mean, he really played his heart out, along with the rest of the guys. I think he was 14 to 18 from the field. Got to get up on this guy. You got to be up, take away the shot. Got to be up, take away the shot. And I'm screaming at D.A., you know you're supposed to be up to take away the shot. A little 1-3-1 defense. Once again, we're not up on the shooter. Too many defensive mistakes, Ray, and those are the things that's going to be addressed this summer and when we start off our summer workouts and school starts back about getting better defensively. It's not about the scoring part, Ray. It's about us getting better defensively. That's C.J. White knocking down the jump shot. You know, both teams was hungry for a win. We both knew what was at stake, the 8th spot. Myron knocking down a 3 right there. Now, once again, we've got to protect the 3-point line. We have to protect the 3-point line, and we didn't do a good job of that. We did a bad job of the 3-point line, and that really hurt us in this game. The good job of pressing and trapping. Now, we just kept pressing and trapping. That's a layup right there by those guys, breaking the trap. You press and trap, you're going to give up some easy ones sometime, but you just got to keep the pressure on. Jordan Jefferson coming off the screen. Nice shot right there. I just kept posting up DA. I mean, he was a tough matchup for them. Just a really tough matchup. Really played well, was physical on both ends of the court. Good job of switching. We're right there. We don't get up on the shooter and take the shot away. And right there, Azell doesn't take the shooter away. Azell taking a rare three out of the corner, and we're steadily trying to keep the pressure on. This game went back and forth. That's a beautiful steal right there by DeAnthony Gordon and a finish. Nice finish.
Did he take an extra step there, Coach?
No, it was a beautiful windmill dunk, though.
Oh, yes, it was.
C.J. White coming off a little DHO play that we run sometime for a wide open shot. Once again, Ray, defensively, I thought we were up and down in the second half. I just thought the last 6-7 minutes of the game, we just got soft and folded.
Well, we were up 17 with 6:50 to play.
And lost the game. And, you know.
And we just became stagnant on the offensive
end. Gave up everything. They got everything they wanted offensively on the other end. And it was nothing I can do. I can't play. Nice move by D.A. right there in the dunk. I mean, he really played good basketball. I mean, he's going to be a force in this league for some years to come. You know, he has confidence. Nice little jump hook. That's his go-to move right there.
Obviously, you're anticipating he may come back.
Yeah, well, I hope he comes back. He has 2 more years of eligibility, so I expect him to come back and play. And we got a team meeting today, and we'll have some individual meetings with our guys. But he's played well. He finally played a whole season, which was good for him. He only played 8 games last year. We're trying to execute here. Nice pass to CJ. Jordan Jefferson for a shot. Like I said, we had control of this basketball game for the last 7-8 minutes of the game, and we just folded, unfortunately, for us, man. And that's the way the year was for us.
And we went cold. And if you think the three-pointer didn't change the game of basketball, all of a sudden they go down and make 2 or 3 threes.
And then right back
gets into it.
The crowd gets into it.
And just hang on to your shorts.
Yeah, we were right here in the game, and we had control. But we, you know, this is how the year went. We're not up on the three-point shooter. No box out right there. Easy put back. And I could see my team, no matter how many timeouts I call, I could see my guys getting folding and getting nervous and playing tight. And I kept saying, don't play tight. Once again, we lose somebody for a shot. I mean, it was so many defensive breakdowns, Ray. It was just unbelievable. So many defensive breakdowns. There's a defensive breakdown right there. We just keep giving up. Well, we're playing not to lose, but what we're doing.
All right, we're up 10 with a little over 3 minutes to go.
Once again, pick and roll, a step up pick. CJ doesn't step up and take the shooter away, knocks down another three. I didn't have to watch the film on this game. I saw every defensive mistake. Once again, CJ doesn't come to the shooter right there. He gets another three. They're all defensive breakdowns. You know, we had our chances to win the game. Now, that was not a foul at all. Nobody touched him at all. Nobody touched him. That was a bad call. Once again, a layup. And there it is, you know, the 85-83, but we kept battling. You know, game sevens, most of the time, are always close. Run a little play there for Jordan Jefferson to knock it down, you know, and won. This game went back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. A blow by, close out, too late, shot. Didn't keep the ball in front of us. When it's dribble penetration, you're going to give up some jump shots sometime, and that's what happened. Once again, Jordan Jefferson with a quick trigger. You know, he played well for us in this game. He played well for us in this game. He really did. They bailed us out with a foul right there. Oh, Isaiah just missed that pass. We leave a shooter shot. I mean, the defensive breakdowns were just staggering. Of course, they're doubling D.A. Nice pass, and that's a flagrant foul right there, and it wasn't called. It should have been a foul and a free throw. This timeout, I told my team, no threes, run them off the three-point line. To stay on top of them, run them off the three-point line. Don't worry about a two. C.J. White lets him get a three off. It's a fine line between winning and losing, and there it was right there, Ray.
All right, we dropped that one 97-96, and that eliminated us from the conference tournament.
Yep.
And so that gets underway in Evansville. And you had a couple of players named Ohio Valley Conference, second team. We'll talk about that when we come back with more of the Darrell Walker Coaches Show. Stay with us.
Great seats at a great price. Get them safer, simpler, and smarter with Ticket Smarter. A proud partner of the biggest names in live sports and events, including ESPN Events and iHeartRadio. Ticket Smarter has seats for over 125,000 live events and 48 million tickets for sale. All backed with the Ticket Smarter 100% ticket guarantee. Thinking about your next great live event? Think smarter. Think Ticket Smarter. Get your tickets your way guaranteed at TicketSmarter.com.
Builds us up. It strengthens our bodies. It strengthens our resolve. Sport teaches us lessons of grace or humility or humanity, and that we're far more powerful together. Winning the hour or winning the year, we're winning our lives. We're winning our way. Because while a season is short, fierce is forever.
Darrell Walker, you had two players make second team Ohio Valley Conference, Myron Gardner and De'Anthony Gordon.
Oh, I thought both guys were deserving. When I got the news last night, I was happy for those guys because they deserved it. They played well. They kept growing as basketball players. You could see the growth all season long, and they both deserved to be second team.
I'm looking at some stats here. Myron Gardner was in double figures, 25 of 30 games. He played with four 20-point games, led the team in rebounding, steals, ranked second on the team in points, 13.2, assists, 3.6, minutes played, over 30 minutes a game, third in both the three-point percentage and free throw percentage.
No, he's an all-around player who I think still has a ceiling, another level that he can go to with some things that Myron has to work on. That's decision-making. That's defensively being ready off the ball. And those are some things that we'll be discussing in my office when the season's over.
De'Anthony,
the season is over for us.
De'Anthony Gordon, what, 36, I think?
35, I believe he was 14 to 18 from the field. You saw his growth all year. Last year, he only played 8 games, so he didn't get a chance to really develop. And this year, he stayed healthy, he played minutes, and he was a terror in the OVC. He's one of the better players in this league.
And the last couple of games, moved out on the floor and started shooting some and knocking those down.
Those are some of the things that I'll be talking to DA about, is the increasing his range and going off the dribble and being a better decision maker with the basketball. But other than that, he hadn't played a lot of minutes, and Myron Gardner really hasn't played a lot of minutes until this season. So you saw the growth, and those guys deserve to be second team OVC.
Darrell Walker, I know what you're going to do. You're going to be real busy on the recruiting trail.
Yeah, I'm going to be recruiting and trying to add some more pieces to this nice nucleus that we have. And I know that we can win the OVC. It didn't happen this year, but I knew we were running a better team, and it just didn't work out for us this year. It kind of reminds me my first year in the Sun Belt, where we won, 10 games overall, and the next year we came back and won it. It's the same thing. I know the league now, so we'll be ready next year.
Darrell Walker, appreciate it very much.
Thanks so much, Ray Tucker.
I'd like to remind folks this show was possible because of Stevens Inc. here in Little Rock. And also thanks to ESPN Plus for airing our show. As you go out and about, don't forget the state high school tournaments are going on. Conference tournaments are going on. Please support high school and college basketball.